spread far and wide, there was less need for zealots. The Inquisitors became the seekers of truth, and eventually the Templars.
And now the Inquisition has been called again to restore order by force.
Do you know what impresses me most about the original Inquisition? They fought horrific battles, killed and died for their cause, and when it was time, they put their swords away. Perhaps the name was divine, Justinia's message, that when the Inquisition is needed, it will strike without mercy. But when its work is done, it will put its sword away.
Do you know who the Grand Clerics will choose as the next divine?
It is a difficult decision. All the obvious candidates perished with Divine Justinia at the Conclave. The Grand Clerics are terrified of the Inquisition. They will not decide soon, and I fear they will not decide wisely. Whoever is chosen needs the Inquisition's support. No one else seems likely to seal the breach.
I don't believe I've had the chance to speak candidly with a revered mother. Can you tell me about the Chantry?
Of course. Too many think that the Chant of Light should only be sung by humans. The truth is that knowledge of the Maker and Andraste should be open to all who wish to learn of him. We believe the Maker created us, and that mankind's sinful nature caused him to turn away. With Andraste's blessing, the Maker will forgive mankind once the Chant of Light is sung from all corners of this world.
Farewell.
Until next time.
Blessed are the peacekeepers, the champions of the just. Blessed are the righteous, the lights in the shadow. In their blood, the Maker's will is written. Is that what you want from us? Blood? To die so that your will is done? Is death your only blessing? You speak for Andraste, no? What does the Maker's prophet have to say about all of this? What's his game?
How is this a game?
Do you see the sky? What about the temple ruins? The bones lying in the dust? Even if you didn't support the Divine's peace, you wouldn't call this right. Who could? So many innocent lives. The faithful murdered where the holiest of holies once stood. If the Maker willed this, what is it if not a game or a cruel joke?
Awful things happen every day. Get used to it.
Get used to being a pawn? To be discarded when the Maker's done with you? The Chantry teaches that the Maker abandoned us. He demands repentance for our sins. He demands it all. Our lives, our deaths. Justinia gave him everything she had, and he let her die.
People are killed all the time.
If the Maker doesn't intervene to save the best of his servants, what good is he? I used to believe I was chosen, just as some say you are. I thought I was fulfilling his purpose for me, working with the Divine, helping people. But now she's dead. It was all for nothing. Serving the Maker meant nothing.
I'm not really the best person to talk to. Doesn't the Chantry have people for this?
So I should let a priest comfort me? No, this is my burden. I regret that I even let you see me like this. It was a moment of weakness. It won't happen again. Come, to work then. We will speak later.
Oh.
I hope that wasn't meant to be me.
What? That?
You obviously don't like somebody.
Did I do the right thing? What I have set in motion here could destroy everything I have revered my whole life. One day they may write about me as a traitor, a madwoman, a fool, and they may be right.
What does your faith tell you?
I believe you are innocent. I believe more is going on here than we can see. And I believe no one else cares to do anything about it. They will stand in the fire and complain that it is hot. But is this the Maker's will? I can only guess.
You don't think I'm the Herald of Andraste?
I think you were sent to help us. I hope you were. But the Maker's help takes many forms. Sometimes it's difficult to discern who it truly benefits, or how. Now, we deal with the Chantry's panic over you before they do even more harm. Then we close the breach. We are the only ones who can. After that, we find out who is responsible for this chaos, and we end them. And if there are consequences to be paid for what I have done, I pay them. I only pray the price is not too high.
You didn't have any choice.
Didn't I? My trainers always said, Cassandra, you are too brash. You must think before you act. I see what must be done, and I do it. I see no point in running around in circles like a dog chasing its tail. But I misjudged you in the beginning, did I not? I thought the answer was before me, clear as day. I cannot afford to be so careless again.
Can't say I'm not grateful to hear that.
I can be harsh, I know. I'm curious. Do you even believe in the Maker?
You're asking me?
You're not a follower of the Kyun. You could be. I suppose it doesn't matter now. I have to believe we were put on this path for a reason, even if you do not. Now it simply remains to see where it leads us. It occurs to me I don't actually know much about you.
What do you want to know?
I'm not sure. Where are you from?
No specific place. My mercenary band worked mostly in the free marches, however.
At least until you crossed the Waking Sea to reach the Conclave, I suppose. Tell me, do you consider the free marches your home? Are you eager to go back?
Wherever I am is home enough for me.
That's how I feel now, after years of tending to business for the Divine.
I'd like to get to know you better.
You would?
Is that a problem?
Not entirely. I'm just curious as to your motivation.
You're a very suspicious person, you know that?
When it's warranted.
I can see why you have some friends.
As you wish. My name is Cassandra Pentagast, daughter of the Royal House of Navarra, 78th in line for the Navarran throne. I joined the Seekers of Truth as a young woman, and was with the Order until they withdrew from the Chantry. I remained as the Divine's right hand, carrying out her order to form the Inquisition. And here we are. That's all there is to know, my lord.
You're a member of Navarra's royal family.
The Pentagasts are a very large clan. Half of Cumberland could say the same.
Really?
No, but it feels that way. I have hundreds of relatives so distant they need charts to prove we're related at all. And they have them. Oh, yes. The Pentagasts value their precious blood like it runs with gold.
So, not on very good terms with your family, then?
I do not visit, if that's what you mean. The Pentagasts are famed for dragon hunting, but few actually pursue the craft. Most are fat and lazy. They pay lip service to the Maker and care only for idle pleasures and past glories. My brother was all that kept me in Navarra. Once he was gone, so was I.
Tell me about your brother.
I would prefer not to speak of Anthony. Another time, perhaps.
You don't seem to like your home that much.
My family polluted it for me. What little I saw of my homeland was through the bars of a gilded cage. My uncle treated me like a porcelain doll to be placed on a shelf and dusted only when necessary. Thus, I did not see Navarra. The real Navarra, until much later. By then, I realized I knew it not at all.
Your uncle? What about your parents?
They had the misfortune of taking the wrong side in the second attempt to overthrow King Marcus. The king executed them, but spared my brother and I since we were family and children at the time. Thus we were raised by my uncle, a mortal Etarsi who preferred the company of his corpses to the living.
Your uncle was a mortal Etarsi?
A death mage. He still is. My countrymen do not burn the dead. They bury them in special crypts. The mortal Etarsi supervise the crypts, like priests. Uncle Vestalus oversees the grand necropolis. Navarrans spend more time honoring dead relatives than they do with living ones. It is odd to be so fascinated with death and its trappings. I will never understand it.
So you were the right hand to the Divine?
To Divine Justinia, yes. And Divine Beatrix before her, in fact. The position is normally reserved for Templars of the Knights Divine, but my circumstances were unusual.
Unusual how?
You don't know the story? Thank the Maker. I will tell you if you wish, but it isn't as exciting as some drum it up to be. The short version is that I once saved the previous Divine's life. My reward was becoming her right hand.
But what does a right hand do, exactly?
What is your hand capable of? It gives, it takes, it beckons. It makes a fist. Liliana and I extended the Divine's reach beyond the Grand Cathedral. We went where she could not. After Beatrix, I was tired of the position and wanted to return to the Seekers. But Justinia convinced me to stay. Her vision for the future gave me hope.
You thought she could really change things?
Justinia knew the war was coming long before it began. She tried to avert it, but the force